because today I have to consolidate so much. But we will keep to a pattern and we will have our little Pan and we'll have Pan Mama and Papa and we will very quickly see what Pan has learned. So today, Pan, will you be playing the naming game? I'll show you things and you have to tell us the name. So when you said this was a part of when we said reading readiness means a good active vocabulary. So please allow a lot of naming games happening all around you. Once you know the words, you can also read because books are a special treat. So we'll be talking a little bit about books and their love for the books. Listen and speak words old and new. You will learn many even if you start with two. It doesn't matter which language you will say them in, right? So this was also what the NEP, the multilingual, bilingual, start with two words and let them go on. I think that's how it's so important. And it also said, draw, sing, cut, paste, cook, and just be. Don't worry about it. And don't think, is this for me? It's good to learn online with tools so smart, but always make time for a little bit of art. It's important to have art integrated into what children can do. And that's what the NEP and Mansa was talking to us about. No one's telling, and then Pan, be safe online. Be safe online. Don't make friends without mommy next to you because you don't know whether they are fit and fine. Pan, you cannot tell anybody about you because that's not fine. Safety online. This is another thing we discussed, you know, with a cyber expert who came in that please keep your children safe. It's important because these are all the things and a responsible citizen you have to be. Do you think you want to feed the birds with me? Do you want to see the wonder of the sun? So there was this little citizenship that we said that create a wonder for nature. Let them just love it. Let them love it so that they feel responsible for it, you know. And it's okay to be happy or sad. It doesn't make you good or bad. It was also about nurturing healthy minds. And then did you go out to play? And is there a special game that you like? If there is a game, quickly tell me your name. So Pan had a lot of things to learn. And the first step that we did on the 11th session was readiness for reading. So what we're also going to do is next week onwards, we're planning on changing the format. So today I'm trying that format and let me see how it's going to work. It's going to be called rapid activities. We are going to not speak so much and whoever is the speaker is actually going to demonstrate a lot of activities. We are going to be doing something a little different from what we've been doing. We'll try to make it like that. So if we want children, when we said literacy, I think this whole Square Panda team, the platform is about people who are researching and wanting to take literacy into that part of India. Each one is making the effort and each of these platforms is one more step towards getting all of us connected to the effort. We all want children to read. All of us want to, but readiness is so, so important. So just 2-3 minutes and we are going to go through a very quick round of readiness activities. So visual discrimination, being able to look at the thing and saying same and different. So I'm going to try and do a couple of very quick activities with you. So every time I show you the same thing, you have to clap your hands. All right. So if it's same, clap your hand. If it's same, clap your hand. Is it same? Clap your hand. If it's not, don't. If it's the same, clap your hand. Starting with two objects, with older children, go on to bigger objects. Another thing very interesting that you can do with children is create a little reading jug, a reading jar, a reading glass, anything transparent, and let the children pick up words and again spot words that look the same. So this gradually makes the older children better quick readers. So if it's the same or not. So it's a simple activity. You do it with objects for the smaller ones and you do it with words for the slightly older ones. It works quite beautifully. And then quickly having a visual memory. So I'm going to show you four things. Can you remember them? So I'm going to show you a sketch pen, a pencil, a dice and a stick. Okay. So can you remember them? So one was also teach your children finger movements, you know, so if you teach the left hand count, immediately the child starts registering. It's a great thing for doing for memory as well as when you do the phonics, when you do the syllables, k, at, or a hip, po, po, t, mus. normally even the bigger words will have about 5 syllables. So please start the use of your left hand. Even if your child is a left-hander for writing, allow the counting to be from the left to right, because the movement is easier like this. This is the way you read, right? So the alignment goes from left to right. The child can do the cut the pencil. There's absolutely no harm in that. But try and keep the left alignment. It works beautifully. A memory tray, something as simple as this. You show a child a few things and hide it. Take away and say, what do you think is missing? The same thing can be done with things around the house. So memory games are fun. You can do it with vegetables. You can do it with something on the table. You can just shift things around the house. Just a lot of... And so what I did today was I picked up some advertisements from the newspaper. I picked up something very, very, an advertisement that says Doodhwale, an advertisement that says Kent, and an advertisement that gives me a sonnet car. And then I just flash it at, if I want to flash it, I flash it at the children. And I say, okay, now I'm going to just show you a part of it. So maybe you can fold it and flash it very quickly and say, what is it? So the older children, and use simple resources. So I think the one thing that we have all learned is that resources have to be valued, and we will not have plenty of resources all the time. So do it even on the digital platforms. Like for example, when you're flashing activities are great fun on digital platforms, because they come and go really fast and you can access a lot of things. So you can use things around the house or screen time for little flashes where the children would learn. It works quite beautifully. Never put your flashcards away. Create these beautiful walls around the house. This is my home, right? So create a reading wall where your children's... So if we create an environment, it works beautifully. Don't buy all the time. You don't need to outsource all the time. You can just use simple tools and you can get them to do the reading. I'll do a very quick activity, because auditory discrimination is also really important. I'm also going to use a couple of tools which we can use. So suppose I tell you clap a pattern. I'm going to. So we were talking about Indian tools. We have the damru, the dholak, the lathi and ghungru. We have the tambourine. India has got a whole lot of it. So try and use a few instruments which are easy to do. So I'm going to do a pattern on this, and you have to clap it. All right. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So come on, do it. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now we're going to change the pattern. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Come on, let's change it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. It's a simple thing, but it gets children to listen to you. You can clap a pattern. You can actually clap and move. So if I clap two times, you will move two steps ahead. If I snap, you will move to the left. So are we ready? Two steps to the left. Forward, left. As simple as this. The children just keep moving. It just is really interesting. You remember we used to have this lovely song that says head, shoulders, knees and toes. So it's a beautiful one to actually isolate visual with the auditory. So head, shoulders, we'll do lips and nose, because I would move down. So head and shoulders, lips and nose. But now what you have to do is, when you have to listen to what I say and not what I do. So are you ready? Okay. So head, shoulders, lips, nose. Head, shoulders, lips, nose. You see how difficult it is when you actually have to move two systems and two things away from each other. So start with two things. Perhaps you can start with just the head and shoulder. Suppose I say head and I put my hand on the shoulder. The child should be able to put the hand on the head. start with 2, go to 3, go to 4, go to 6, and just make it more and more interesting. Movement from left to right is so important. I'll tell you one very beautiful thing that I did many years back. You know, today we are talking about change, activities, but there are such beautiful songs that, you know, that lend themselves to sequencing a process. Do you remember there's this beautiful song that said, Chun chun karti aayi chidiya dal ka dana laayi chidiya, mor bhi aaya, bandar bhi aaya, chuha bhi aaya, chun chun karti aayi chidiya. So there was a whole sequence, dal ka dana laayi chidiya, mor bhi aaya, bandar bhi aaya, chuha bhi aaya. And bachche ko gaana hai, suna dijiye. Aur bole, please draw it in that sequence. You know, there are so many things that you can do with the way things are around you. Just use the music, use the beats. They're beautiful things. We had this, we had a lovely speaker called Poonam, who did our Gungunati Kahaniya. So sing little stories with your children, do that. So that is what makes things. So that was our first, the 11th one. We then came to nurturing the love for books. And Ira was there with us. And she's from Jodhpur. She runs the Kitabo, the literary fest. I just hope it opens up again. And, you know, the whole world can see these vibrant, beautiful people doing beautiful work. We'll keep wishing. It doesn't matter. We will keep doing our bit and wishing. So she said a few very interesting things. She said, just let them read anything from anywhere. Don't look for these perfect book sets for them. Let them read anything from anywhere. Love for books can come from them following another art. For example, if the child wants to be a good singer or an artist, invariably the child will have to sometime pick up a book for a reference. So allow that wonder to come in. Create book clubs. Collect books. Create book clubs. Create family hand-me-down books, you know, where the family names are written. You know, in spite of all this beautiful digital time, it's so beautiful when you pick up a book in which there is a name of your grandfather written. Don't allow this wonder to go away. And that's our strength of our country. We have generations living together. We have to allow grandparents to talk about their favorite book. Allow them to sit down with the children, encourage the children to listen to them. They may not be able to read granddad's favorite book today, but please remember he's or she's absorbing. They just may go and ask for the book a couple of years down the line. We've seen it happen with our children. So allow that to happen. Exchange of books is so important. Don't every time keep buying books for your children. Exchange books. It's a beautiful process. Read yourself. And like we discussed it, create this little treasure box in which after every few weeks, you know, put in a list of names of authors or books and lay those out on the bookshelf and then circulate your books. So even if the children have 20 books, let them revisit the books regularly. It works so beautifully. So set up a small place where the children can actually enjoy this part of it. Don't put away the books. Circulate them. Put them away, then take them out, then circulate them. There is always a wonder. Add a lot of art to your books. For the grown-up children, give them a little piece of paper and pencil and said, write the character of the book. Could you see who the author of the book was? Who were the characters in the book? What is in the back of the book? Did you see the preface of the book? Did you like the cover of the book? Would you like to make your own book? Oh, there is so much that you can do without telling them, chalo, aaj 5 minute book padhna hai. Not required. There is just so much to take care and do. And fortunately, we have our guests who've been coming. They've been actually taking us through such beautiful processes, So chalte chalte, you will explain the part of the book. Oh my God, isme to dog ears hai. Isko to khol dete hai. Let's iron these dog ears out. Would you like to reread the book? Would you like to read it and tell me? So emotional quotient, somebody was asking for nuclear families. we are going to get a fantastic person, I think, around the 4th of October. Somebody from Indore, and he speaks beautifully on social emotional development. I think it will help us, right? So whatever I'm noticing, I'm trying to. So yes, in nuclear family systems, then that's what he's going to talk about. We'll wait for him to be saying that, right? Now we came to nurturing healthy minds, exactly what you're talking, you know. So nurturing healthy minds. So today I'm going to be speaking alone. So my voice has to be fit and fine for all of you. So Dr. Dipti was there with us. Now, you know, each person who's coming to speak have been people who I have come across at some point of time. These are people who have influenced me. They are people who have, I have seen grow, you know. So I think, so she said something very beautiful. She said, what is important is to have a mirror. अपने आप को भी शीशे में देखिए, बच्चों को भी देखने दीजिए. It's okay, you have to tell them. And please remember what she said. There were a couple of things she said, which I really absorbed to myself. She said, play is important. You have to let children be. You have to let them make errors. You have to let them, you know, just be and do their own thing. When they're sitting and doing their own thing, please don't feel they're doing nothing. Another thing which she told so importantly was that anxiety is a learned behavior. Children can actually mirror your anxiety. So be very careful when you have difficult moments, and these are not the easiest of times. We all know it. We all know what's going wrong in the systems. But do not allow this time to become an anxiety time for your little one. I have been saying this, and I have been also saying this to everybody who's talking on webinars. Let's not make this to be bigger than it is. It's already very, very difficult for the adults. Let's try and make it a little easier for the children. We all know what we are facing, right? But allow, so anxiety, if it's there on you, the mirror will show it to the child. So please remember this. Moods and feelings, conflicting messages. She said these beautiful things. She said that you can't give them messages which are conflicting. Today one thing, tomorrow another thing. Another thing she said was very beautiful, that you kind of tell them, you bachche thodi na rote, boys thodi na rote, or you're making them think in a particular way. Try and not do that. So we will keep getting people. There's another lovely person I know. So what I do is I try and invite them, and most of them have been kind. So mirroring, be careful with your anxiety at this time. Be a little cautious. I think it's important. Be very careful on how, you know, the spouses are talking. Teachers, please be careful with teachers. They're all working really hard. Also observation. Now, today we were thinking also that we are putting up an observation checklist like this. You know, it's a simple column. We haven't filled up the column. Now, I'll go to the next step and I'll tell you how all these other things are going to get connected to this observation checklist. We have this beautiful young team of the Square Panda, young girls, and our designs come from any part of the world. And I think there are different designers that sit in, I think, US. So it's like a beautiful collaboration of young minds. And every time I ask them for something, they make it so possible, you know. So this little thing, we're going to take the next step after this. And then we said, building little citizens. What all would a good little citizen be? And we invited two guests, Ria and Colonel S.M. Kumar. Two very different. One was, it's all of 22, and one has served the nation in uniform and is a decorated soldier. So Ria so beautifully makes these small bird houses for feeding birds. So I found it wonderful. That do your children ever think of feeding a bird, giving it water, just looking at, you know, plants, taking care of them, just allow them to love nature. I think that's a very, very important learning for a good country. Colonel S.M. Kumar said something so beautiful. In fact, I asked him to send it to me, you know, that today the only survival that the children need is the ability to adapt very, very fast. We don't know what's coming. We don't know what to prepare them for. But we have to prepare a temperament that can be help them to adjust. So he wrote, I requested him to write this down, which he's very kindly sent to me. It says that the pace of technology-enabled innovation actually was like, is completely disruptive. The television took, 75 years, it took telephone to reach 75 years to reach 50 million people. The radio took 38 years to reach people. The TV took 13 years, internet took 4 years, Facebook took 3 years, WhatsApp and Instagram took about a year and a half, a game called the Angry Birds, 35 days, something called the Pokemon Go, 19 days. And maybe there are a few things which are now, which just come overnight. So that's the pace of change. We need to just prepare the children. So set your rhythms, set them to be in a certain way. And that's how the children, so now somebody tells me, let's prepare them for the future. I don't even know if the schools are going to open 6 months from now. I have no idea. So I say, make their today the best we all can. Make it so comfortable, make it mentally so strong that the child keeps adapting to change, because if you are a well-contained individual, you will adapt much faster than a person who's not a very, very, comfortable in the mind person. So mental health is extremely important, our mental health. You know, the day I am disrupted, I have a little pet who's 12 and a half. Even that little creature looks at me and says, oh my God, she's not looking okay. Hovers around, is uncomfortable. So imagine if I can send such signals to this little creature in my house. And he's like this amazing emotional quotient reflection. So it's like my mirror. He's this little magic mirror I have. And I say, oh my God, I better behave. So children are far more sensitive. Let's be very careful. And then it was very interesting because we talked about the NEP and Mansa came on. Mansa is somebody who works with the CCE, the evaluation. I am trying to make this assessment and observation a small part of our process today just to help you to make this possible at home. So she said a few things which said multilingual important, art, so important in learning. Allow it to come into your children's life and allow for competency-based learning, not ki bas learning ho gaya for today and it's over. No. What are they going to do with that learning? She used one particular concept which I asked her to explain to me today. It said benign neglect. Now, I asked her what it means. So she says that opposite of helicopter parenting, allow the children to be. And I think each speaker in their own way has told us this. Allow them to experiment, allow them to fall, allow them, give them time to recover. Let them make sense of what is happening. And please remember, it's a very fast moving world today. So allow children to figure it out. Do not push them beyond what, I'm seeing a lot of parents who are putting children in everything that is being advertised. It's not required. Your kids are going to be fine with things they want to do. Please allow that to happen. If your child wants to be just an artist, allow that to happen. Coding is the next big word. And please remember, it may not be for everybody. You and me will survive without it. And I may just need it really. I may just want to do it and be very happy. So allow for that little scope of what. It doesn't have to be for everybody. And this observation checklist is a simple checklist. I'll explain what you can do with it. Now, when we talk about assessment in school, we talk about observation in schools. We have many, many criteria for the teachers. We tell them to make portfolios. We tell them to observe the child short term. We tell them to observe the child after 4 weeks and so on and so forth. And then they have to make these pen pictures and then they have to explain it to parents. It's a long process of assessment. I have always been of the opinion that observation, basic recording, is enough to tell me what my children need to do in the next step. That's how I have always used it. I have always told my teachers, we don't need to do so much of recording of the child's ability, because by the time you finish recording the 30th child, the first child has already changed. It is that dynamic in early years. So simple observation, what you can do is every week, this is also for the teachers, please give parents a developmental indicator that for spelling, this is what your children should know. For math, this age group should know this much. For language, this much. Art, these are the options. And then allow a little bit of an observation saying that, you know, does the child need to be nurtured and forced? Is the child independent? Is the child independent and confident? I just put two, three categories. One thing was said that you have to keep nudging and pushing the child. The child is independently doing things, is independently and confidently doing it. That means little less pushing that child will need. So a little nudge here and there, a little path created, wo thoda clap and click ke saath, let them move on to direction. It works beautifully. In case you want to change this, and you know why I'm asking you to do this is, today the teacher does not have access to this part of your child. So what she used to so painstakingly do, observe, record and give it to you, you have to help the teachers out just a little bit and tell them that this part of it, we would like you to help. So when she sees, oh my God, the child is not responding to this, she'll automatically make her plans a little differently. So please don't feel that the teacher is not working and making you work. No, you are just helping her to work better for your children. I think that is what this whole observation checklist is all about. Please remember, repetition is necessary. Consolidation is necessary. You can't do an activity with the children and never do it again. You have to come back to it. And you have to come back to it with different ways to do it. I think that's the whole magic of what we want to see in our children. So please, parents, if it's possible, kindly make a little observation checklist. Teachers who are here, please make one, maybe list of observations for the week, maybe two observations for the week, and ask the parents to help you out. And I think this is not a time to say who's doing what. It's let's do this together, right? So this can be downloaded. They have it on their thing. You can just click it and download it. And thank you, girls, for this very beautifully done little, observation chart for us. So after this, we had Ashish. Now, Ashish heads Square Panda in India. And it was very interesting that in so many days, of us taking on the platform, he's never given me an instruction of doing this, do that. I want to do this. And it was crazy because I actually invited him on a show which his company is hosting for all of us. And he came so beautifully and he said a few things which I felt so important. So I'm an author with the Oxford University Press, and I have written the first earlier series called My Learning Train. It's an activity-based series and I cover all the subjects. So I do a Hindi, I do colors, I do math, I do literacy, I do, world around me. So I'm really blessed because, and each time I am doing, I'm just doing the phonic capsule for my new books called The World of Phonics. So when I did the phonics, I started looking for platforms for the skills. Where would children get visual discrimination? Where would they be able to, put a finger? Where would there be self-correction? So because I've downloaded their app and a couple of other apps, it's very interesting because when I navigate, I realize that what he was saying is that it's research-based. They look at it and say that this is how little children can actually explore and learn on their own. I asked him a question and I said that, so how should we prepare the parents and teachers? So he just smiled and said, well, we want to empower the children. We want the teachers and parents to be with them, but we want to empower the children. And another very interesting thing is, like, I asked you to keep these observation records. When you do digital work, which is scientifically done, which does not need the child to be on the screen for like 20 hours, just for a short time, that also records the navigation of the child. that records the speed with which a child is doing a particular thing and slowly nudges the child towards the direction the child may need. Now, this is something which you call the use of data to help an individual observation and a corrective. So sometimes I feel that a part of the digital solutions may be able to help us to create these little parts where, you know, we data collection for teachers is so big. So I think when this whole pandemic is over, please start taking a little more help from the the digital tools to be able to compile what you so painstakingly do. Your overseeing is more than enough and it will help you. That's my take. I have been a totally hands-on person. So when I see something different, I do talk about it because I think it's important for us to discuss these things. Now, the next topic, which was a little scary, was keeping children safe online. So while I was talking to you, I also have a cyber security person who works in the cyberspace, Sanjeev. And he looked at me and said that, do you know how unsafe the children can be? And the things he told me actually scared the wits out of me. And I said, my God, why did I not see it like this? And we discussed on how many, many educational people are ensuring complete safety of the children. They are making their system so perfect that the children are safe onto those platforms. But what happens is when the child has a digital device, there are things popping up. There are other things that the child does. So I asked them for 5 little tips for keeping children safe online. And the first tip was to set up genuine operating systems. And when you're setting up devices for children, ensure that the firewalls are not bypassed, all safety norms, all good antiviruses. So that's the step one. Ensure the use of a smart device by the child where you can see the child. So eye contact, just be around the child. You don't have to be sitting right next to the child. But generally be with the children when they are on an online platform. Educate the children not to click on pop-up links. Don't click. Tell them you're not to click because suddenly something will pop up. They may click on it and it could just create a big disaster for either the child or even your financial or whatever safety of your data. Do not encourage games that they play with strangers, you know, Ludo, Snakes and Ladders, where they're playing with strangers online. You don't know who these people are. These are not friends. Friends are people you know for children, please. So I think this whole online friendship thing has really taken things to a very unsafe. Tell them they're not to give any information to anybody who asks for it till you are there. Right? I think that's important. So keeping records. So what can you do to make the online learning fun a little better? Please start recording the amount of screen time the children have. It's important to do that. Set limits. Follow them. There is no negotiation on that. Follow them. Take corrective measures as soon as you see it. If you're seeing there is there are restless children. They are crying when the devices are taken away. There is a panic. There is a lot of trauma in the houses. So just when it's starting, please talk to other parents, talk to teachers, talk to experts and see how we can, you know, stir the child into another. And a little bit of outdoor time is all very important to help the children to understand that this needs to be done. All right. So online safety is what we talked about. All right. I will just... we also discussed some. Oh, so it was really interesting because what we did was we went through. I don't know whether you all can see this. I think I should just switch on the light if you just give me a minute. So now we know the winter setting in because the light, the light, otherwise it never went away. So nurturing readiness, you had the love of books from Ira. We had nurturing healthy minds, little citizens with Tanlesem Kumar and Ria. We had Ashish. We had Mansa with the NEP. online safety, and then we had a very, very interesting set of two sisters, Janvi and Hiteshi, with their mother. Now, these children pursue the game of golf, and I called them in because I thought that it was very important for us to understand that sometimes some games are this, they are expensive games, they are games which require, but creating champions means a lot of work from the parents and teachers, because children will miss school, children will have to be taken to a sports center, and that's where you know, it's important that the parents get involved. I asked Mrs. Bakshi, I said, Sunita ji, how important is it when your you know, when your children are, I mean, when they become champions, or the journey to them? So she said, if they do 90%, we have to do 300%. And I said, my God. Because she said, I have to wake up earlier than them, I have to have a better routine than them. Then I asked her about the school, and she said something so beautiful. These children study in APS Dholakua. And she said that in so many years, nobody has ever stopped them from leaving, you know, a week of school. And everybody just said, no, things are going to be fine, and don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. So the kind of support teachers give, the kind of encouragement and routine of parents is just so, so important. It's really important. So like I said, we consolidated our 9 days. We consolidated 9 sessions with 9 wonderful, in fact, more than 9 wonderful people. It was almost, I think, 15 of them. I think as a platform and as people who interact, who meet, it's very, very important that we keep meeting interesting people. Like I said, what I'll just very quickly go through this observation part just once more. So that when you go back, so teachers, you all need to do a couple of things. You all need to make lists per week, which the parents will observe. You can actually have a repetitive pattern so that very, very comfortably the children can, the parents can keep observing. Give them options. So suppose you want them to do a reading skill, give them 5-6 options for activities. You don't always have to do it straightforward. I mean, like on a live session. You can just record, or you can list out things and send it. I think this listing out has been a very, very big tool. So I work with a lot of schools, and I was telling them what's working best. So they said, ma'am, when you send the lists out, they work. And then to create a pattern of a feedback. So how will they send this to you? You all have apps from your school. You have systems. You can just take a photograph and send it to the teacher. And also don't expect miraculous solutions. So you are sending an observation, the other person will note it down, and that will be just simply integrated into the next set of planning. I think in these conditions, this would be the simplest way to do things, because we can't expect something very complicated. And also the other day, I was also listening to, will the children not develop, or will there be an issue, or will there be a problem? I'm a very strong believer in the fact that if we all keep working together, we've come this far, we'll see this year through, right? The artificial intelligence section. No, I have not forgotten the artificial intelligence section, but please understand that artificial intelligence. Oh yes, I did forget about that part. Yes, my God. So I didn't bring that on. I think, yes, when Ashish was speaking, so we brought in Pradyut to talk to us about artificial intelligence and how it's going to impact. So, ma'am, while, yes, I did not mention it, and thank you for correcting me, that's what families are all about. And we are making a good 5 o'clock family on a Sunday. So what was so important about is that why I was talking about the individual observation. When you can observe children and their development, and then put it together as data to help that particular child, that is where the artificial intelligence came in, you know. And I think that this one comment from Preeti, I think this is beautiful. Preeti, thank you so much that, you know, you actually remember to say these things to me. Thank you for the help and support. So these many people, these many things, like I said, we did the reading, we did the books, we did the mental, you know, nurturing mental health and making children feel better and happier, creating good citizens. And Mansa, with the beautiful way she unfolded the NEP for us. Then we had Ira, we had so many people. So thank you so much. And we are looking forward to next Sunday. Next Sunday is going to be exciting. It's going to be rapid activities with science and stories. So I found this wonder teacher who actually told me a story about the digestive system on how the apple went into the mouth. And then, my God, it was like a wonder. So we are going to look forward to seeing you. And next week is going to be a rapid activity time. I will practice and I will come and we will have a rapid 40, 45 minutes, right? So thank you so much. Have a good evening and enjoy your weekend. And Pankaji, thank you so much. Square Panda team, thank you for this beautiful platform that you keep giving us. And bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Next time with science. Okay? And bye-bye.
Square, square, panda.